Hello guys, welcome to my channel and today we are going to make mechanum wheel. So these are omnidirectional wheel and we can move in any direction with the help of this kind of wheel. So let's get started. So first we will begin with the design of the mechanum wheel. So I have already designed it and you can see the 3D CAD model of it. After removing the top cover, you can see from inside. As you can see, these are made from 3 different parts along with 12 rollers which are assembled with each other. You can download all the files from the link in the description. I have already 3D printed all its parts. If you don't have a 3D printer, then you can make one by yourself by clicking on the I button. In the bottom part, I have already inserted 3 M3 nuts and secured them with the help of glue gun so that they won't come out. And here is the Y connector to mount the motor with the wheel. And I am using a 100 RPM motor. First connect the Y connector with the bottom part of the wheel and then insert the motor in the Y connector. Make sure that the whole alignment of the motor shaft and the Y connector is proper. And then insert a M3 bolt of 10mm inside it. Now each wheel has a set of 12 rollers which is attached with the help of 3mm shaft of length 52mm. Here I am using 30cm length, out of which 5 shafts can be cut. And make sure of leaving a clearance of 1mm or 2mm while cutting smaller shafts from the big one. So first assemble all the rollers on the outer part of the wheel. You can choose the motor RPM according to your requirement, but don't go beyond 150 RPM because the rollers are made of 3D printed material and they are brittle in nature. So the friction between the roller and the contact surface is very less and thus our wheel will skid. Now take 3 M3 size screw of 20mm length and insert it in the bottom part. Now carefully place this bottom part above the top part while maintaining the alignment of the holes and then slightly tighten the screws, but make sure not to completely tighten the screws. Now carefully pull the outer end of the wheel and insert the shaft in it. And since these are 3D printed and are elastic in nature, thus it won't get damaged. The assembly of the wheel is completed and apart from neglecting the rough surface, the design is perfect. Now apart from moving in forward and backward direction, these wheels tend to move in slant direction with respect to the roller position. But for that we need another wheel, but make sure that the orientation of roller is reversed. Now when the sets of wheels are rotated in opposite direction, they tend to move in sideward direction. Now I will explain how these type of wheel works. So if you don't want to learn that, you can skip to the end. So let us consider two wheels whose rollers are in opposite direction. The top wheel is rotating in anti-clockwise direction and the bottom wheel in clockwise direction. Now the force exerted will be normal to the roller direction. Now dividing these force in components will give us two components, F1 cos theta, F1 sin theta, F2 cos theta and F2 sin theta. Now since F1 cos theta and F2 cos theta are in opposite in direction and are of same magnitude, thus they cancel each other. And now we are only left with F1 sin theta plus F2 sin theta and thus the wheel will move in rightward direction. Now we will reverse the wheel rotation and perform the same calculation. Again here f1 cos theta will cancel f2 cos theta and we are left with f1 sin theta and f2 sin theta, and thus our wheels will move in leftward direction. And this was the basic concept of the mechanism wheel. But we cannot utilize these properties until we have 4 sets of wheel. So in my next video I will use these wheels and make something out of it. Till then you can enjoy my other videos. So if you like this video then give it a thumbs up and don't forget to subscribe the channel.